Start 11, another Start Menu replacement. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. It's no surprise that Windows 11's Start Menu and Taskbar changes are probably some of the most controversial aspects of the operating system. It's nothing new. I mean, we went through kind of sort of the same thing with Windows 10's Start Menu. The good news is that there are Start Menu replacements. In fact, I previously covered something called OpenShell, a free and open source Start Menu replacement. What I want to introduce you to here is Start 11, a commercial alternative. Start 11 is developed by a company called Stardock. It's pretty easy to find by search. We'll go ahead and do that. I'm just going to search for Start 11. And the very first result here, at least at Bing, is in fact the product, Start 11. Like I said, it's a commercial product, but it's actually fairly inexpensive. I'm not going to call out the prices because the prices will change. They'll differ depending on where you are. But if this is at all interesting, I do suggest you take a quick look at the pricing in your area at the time you see this, just to see what it is you'd be looking at. We're going to go ahead and dismiss their little newsletter and try free. It is in the process of downloading, or it will be shortly, so we'll go ahead and do that. I'm going to save this just because I like to save things like this. You can see I've already got my OpenShell set up from the previous examples, and we'll download it. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and open it or run the installer. At this point, we're done with the browser, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that. Naturally, there is a license agreement to agree to. Now, it does seem to spend a little bit of time here on this installing services. Not sure why that is. I'm just clicking on the Start 11 dialog behind it. If you have purchased it, you would enter a product key. If you're going to purchase it, you can purchase a product key or you can start your 30-day free trial. I'm going to run this one with a 30-day free trial. It does require that you verify an email address. Of course, we did need the browser to at least be able to click on the link that we got in email. I'll go ahead and close the browser yet again, and it's noticed that it's been activated. We'll hit finish. Now, there are a lot of features in Start 11. I'm going to focus on just a couple of what I consider to be the most important and in at least one case, the most requested feature, at least the most complained about feature that's missing from Windows 11. We start, of course, with the classic issue of do we want the Start menu to be in the middle or on the left? That actually is a Windows 11 configuration option, but you can highlight it here in Start 11. Since I already have left aligned, I'm going to go ahead and run with that. Now we have all the different kinds of Start menus that you can start with. For example, right now we've got the Windows 7 style Start menu. In fact, if I were to click on the Start button right now, there it is, the Windows 7 style of Start menu. Naturally, there are a number of different styles, including Windows 10 and Windows 11. If you, for example, upgraded to Windows 11 and you missed the Windows 10 style Start menu, well, you can have that back too, if that's what you're interested in. You can, of course, make various other changes to it, but that's the basic. You can choose a variety of different Start menu styles that more appropriately fit your specific intent. Now you'll notice here it says configure menu. I'm going to click on that because we can do a variety of different things to the Start menu itself. For example, some of the things that you can see are configurable here are things like the colors that you might want to have, its transparency or not. A highly requested option is to change the fonts that are being used or their size in the Start menu. You can change visual effects, use a custom menu background, use a custom grid tile background if you want things to lay out the way you want them to be. Over here on Start Button, I'm going to do something a little interesting. I'm going to use a custom start button image. So I'll click on that. At that point, I have the option of choosing several different styles. Now, you can download your own. You can, if you want to, create your own image for your start button. I am not interested in doing that, but I am interested in changing it to something else. I happen to like using the paw as my start button. That basically tells me that I'm running, or reminds me that I'm running Start 11 for my start menu. And you can see that that change happened immediately. There it is. There's the paw along with my current Windows 7 style start menu. The setting that I think is going to be the most exciting for many people who have complained about the Windows 11 taskbar is this one. In taskbar, on the left-hand side, scroll down, scroll way down, and you'll see taskbar position. Align bottom, align top, or align left and align right. I'm going to go ahead and tap on align right. In this case, because it's this major a change, explorer.exe, the program that actually displays the taskbar, needs to be shut down and restarted. So we're going to let it do that. And there it is. After a couple of seconds, the taskbar is now over here on the right-hand side. I can click on the start button, which is up at the top. I have the icons representing all of the items that are running on my system. As you can see, it's align right or align left, whichever you would like it to be. Like I said, this one I think is going to make a lot of people very, very happy. I'm going to go ahead and turn it back to align bottom. And once again, it needs to restart Explorer, which is responsible for displaying the taskbar. Taskbar size. A lot of people are interested in making it a little bit larger, so we'll go ahead and hit large. Again, another restart of Explorer to make it happen. And there it is, a bigger taskbar. There's one more thing I want to show you. Like I said, there's a lot to be explored here, but there's one more thing that I think is worth understanding, and that's this item over here called Control. Clicking the Start button opens the Start 11 menu. Well, we know that. Example, I just clicked on it and I get the Windows 7 style Start menu. Pressing the Windows key opens, well, you can have it do that, or if you like, you can have it open the Windows menu. What that means is, it will open whatever Windows has for a menu. By that I mean if I click, I get the Windows 7 style. If I type the Windows key, I get the Windows 11 style without Start 11's getting in the way. So you can have it both ways if you want to. The other thing that's worth understanding is that right-clicking on this will give you the normal right-click menu, but if, for example, you have closed the settings window, if you shift and right-click on it, you now have this option for Configure Start 11, which brings up the very same configuration menu that we've been using. Honestly, this is one of those things where I really do think it's worth experimenting with during the free trial. You may find that this is what you need to make the Windows 11 Start and Taskbar experience something much easier for you to live with if you're resisting some of the changes that came with Windows 11. Now, full disclosure, I've actually paid for Start 11 myself, but I'm not currently using it. I used it for several months. I ended up transitioning back to the Windows 11 menu and taskbar experience because I felt it was important for me to get used to what Windows 11 can do, not only because I'm answering questions about it all the time, but that's generally my philosophy, is to try and get used to the technology so that I'm having to make fewer customizations in order to use the system. All that being said, if this is something that could make a significant difference for your comfort using Windows 11, Start 11 might be a very, very useful tool. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/180483. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.